Welcome back, everybody. My name is Adam Brewer, and I'm a Security and Compliance Senior Technical Specialist at Microsoft. And today we're going to do a second video in my series of technical demos of Microsoft security solutions. So today what we're going to look at is something called Conditional Access App Control. This is an integration between Azure Active Directory, our identity and access management platform, and Microsoft Cloud App Security, our cloud access security broker solution. And what this is helpful for is adding additional controls around third-party and first-party SaaS applications. So applications that live in the cloud, things like Salesforce.com or Box or any of those kinds of applications. And so I want to give you a quick demo of this in action with a couple of different scenarios around a user accessing these applications from an unmanaged device. So a device that is not issued by your organization and you have no control over it. So let's jump in and get started. So here we have my Azure portal. And what we're going to start with, much like last time, is conditional access. So we're going to jump over to the security pane, jump over to conditional access, and finally into our policy. This one I've named CAAC, or Conditional Access App Control, for Salesforce. And that's what we're going to demo today. And by the way, if you want to learn how to build out these policies in your own environment, head over to aka.ms/CAAC. Okay, so let's look at this policy. We're going to target my sales and marketing team. And we're going to target both Salesforce as well as Microsoft Teams. Again, both third and first party support. And by the way, on that note of third party support, any third party SaaS application that you have federated with your Azure Active Directory environment is eligible to be used with this technology. It doesn't require it to be on any special list, although there are applications where we have additional features on a featured list. Next, we'll look at conditions. And for conditions, we're looking at two things. First off, we're going to make sure that we're coming in through a browser or a modern client, although this is a browser-centric technology. And then we're going to exclude managed devices. So there's two kinds of managed devices that we are excluding. And it's really a conversation for another day. But just know that both Intune managed devices as well as domain joined devices can be excluded from these policies. Now we're going to get into our controls. We're going to allow access, but we are going to require multi-factor authentication because this is from an untrusted device and we don't have that signal to support the sign-in. So we need some additional confidence in the sign-in that it is the user we think it is. And also what we're going to do is enable a session control for conditional access app control. Now we've built in a couple of policies right here, monitor only or block download mode. If you use these, you don't have to do anything inside of Cloud App Security to get it going. But I'm going to do custom policies because I want to do some policies over on the Cloud App Security side of the world and want you to see what those look like. So let's pivot over there right now. So this is Cloud App Security, and I have two policies that are session policies, and these are real-time controls. So as the user is accessing the site, we can control it. So let's look at each one of these briefly. First one is applying Azure Information Protection to .docx files. So a really simple policy, we're looking for a file download with inspection where the app equals Salesforce and the device is not Intune compliant or hybrid joined. And the file extension we're looking for is .docx. So really simple policy here where we're just based on the file extension, probably something you wouldn't use in real world scenarios, but wanted to keep it simple for today's demo. We actually can integrate with either a built-in DLP engine inside of Cloud App Security or the Microsoft Unified Data Classification Service, and we can look for things like sensitive information types. So for example, social security number, credit card number, that sort of thing. When we find a file that is a .docx file and is being downloaded from Salesforce, we're going to apply our confidential finance label, just again as an example. And if we can apply a label, we're going to block the download. Okay, so we'll turn on that policy. And I have one other policy I want to show you before we switch over to the user experience. And this is another simple policy where we're just going to control the file download, but instead we're going to look for file extension equals PDF, and we're going to block the download entirely. And we're going to do a custom message that says, hey, Bruco, which is my organization, doesn't allow PDF file downloads on unmanaged devices. You need to use your Bruco issued device if you want to download the file. Simple enough. So let's switch over and see what this is like for an end user. We're going to mix and match a couple of different technologies here in action. So first off, I'm signed in as my demo user, and one thing I want to land with you is that I can go to my other applications like Outlook without any issue. I am choosing to selectively enforce MFA only in certain scenarios. So that's really powerful capability of Azure Active Directory, where I don't have to put MFA on everything. This user just signed in with their password and I allow them to get to their email, but when they try to go to Salesforce, we're going to get a different experience. So let's go back and try that out now. So I'm going to go to just my third-party apps app grouping, which is a new feature of our My Apps experience, by the way. And we're going to jump into Salesforce. Now, what I'd expect to happen based on the policy we just looked at together is that I'm going to be prompted for multi-factor authentication. And there it is, right on cue. So I'm going to hop into the authenticator app on my iPhone and approve that prompt. There we go. Now, I get a message from Cloud App Security that says, hey, and by the way, this is all customizable to your organization. Functionality is going to be limited because you're using an unmanaged device, and I can choose to suppress this notification. By the way, if you don't want to show this to users at all, you don't have to. And also notice that my company logo is there in the lower left corner. So we'll continue to Salesforce. Now I want you to notice in the URL bar, it's kind of tiny, but you may be able to see that there's a .cas.ms at the end of the URL. That indicates we are going through our cloud proxy right now, which is co-located in many of our Azure data centers to allow high performance. You'll notice Salesforce loaded just as fast as if I was accessing it natively. So we like to really deliver that transparent, seamless experience that users aren't going to really feel is degraded from their normal experience of directly accessing the application. So I'm going to go over to my Salesforce files here. And first we'll look at this PDF file. Now I can click on the PDF file and view it right here in the browser through Salesforce's built-in preview engine. But when I try to download it, again, I'm on an unmanaged device, I'm gonna get a message that that is blocked. So this has been blocked by my organization's security policy, and again, customized message. Let's try that docx file here. So here's a proposal. It's a Word doc, so we're gonna try to download this. Now the download's gonna succeed, but what has happened is in real time, at the time of click, Cloud App Security intercepted that message and wrapped it with Microsoft Information Protection in real time. This is pretty cool stuff. So now when I try to open this file here, it's gonna kick me over to Microsoft Word, and notice that I'm in a complete read-only mode because this label that has been applied against this document does not allow printing, does not allow cut, copy, paste, doesn't allow pretty much anything. So here I can try to highlight some text and do a right click, can't copy it. If I were to try to print this, I notice that print is grayed out in the menu bar. And notice as well, I'm on a Macintosh right now. People always think Microsoft stuff is Microsoft centric. Not anymore, not your father's Microsoft. This technology, Microsoft Information Protection, works across macOS, iOS, Android, and Windows, and the web. So no matter where you're accessing our Office apps, you're gonna get that same experience and that same protection, regardless of platform. So today, to recap, we combine technologies from Azure Active Directory, from Microsoft Cloud App Security, and from Microsoft Information Protection, and stitch them together in a single quick demo, showing you the way you could deliver a productive experience to your users, even when they're not on a company-managed device, but limiting their functionality to keep your organization safe. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hit that like button, give me a comment, and we'll keep them coming next week. Thanks so much for watching.